Good morning, my beautiful people. Today is day 47 of running from my family cult, the Kudaroffs. How many of you thought I would make it this long? None of you. I know. Me neither. It's okay. I never thought I would have to do something like this. We never really know what we're made of until we have to see, I guess, right? So today is Sunday. It's early. Sunday is the best blog readership day of the week. So if you're a writer out there, you best be spamming early in the morning. So that's what I did, and I'm being punished for it already. It didn't take long. They act like I'm just gonna lay down and die. If I was gonna do that, I wouldn't even have started this adventure. And I realize now how much they have been punishing me my whole life. I got breast cancer because A1 poisoned me when I was writing my second book, because it actually had potential. My book editor was motivated by the dark side, so he was really hard to work with and scammed me out of a lot of things. Everyone has always been more invested in my failures than my successes. And yet, here I am. And I realized today that I know more people who are going to hell than I know who are going to heaven. I don't think I know anyone who's actually been a good person. That was a little disturbing. It was an awful realization. And I'm not saying I'm perfect by any means. No way. There's no way I could. No one's perfect. We're all human. I've made mistakes just like everybody else. It's all about the ratio of your mistakes and your intention. I just want to be a good person. And then I also have to take into account that other people just aren't going to invest in me, because why would they put anything on the line for me? Like, I'm not worth being a good person over. That's what they looked at it like. I don't have anything to offer. The only person who looked at me like I had something to offer that was even remotely worthwhile risking anything over was A1, and he still destroyed me. He destroyed me pretty hardcore. Like, I'd never had a cavity until I was with him, and I still have only had, I think, one or maybe two, but that's from lead exposure, because lead gets absorbed into your calcium receptors, so it affects your teeth. And then the cancer. I was sweating bullets, literally, when I was writing my second book. I was just trying to pull it together, He was poisoning me so bad. And he hung out with me during that time too, so he could watch me. It's not just, you know, poison my stuff. Like, I loved protein shakes, and he poisoned my protein shakes. And every time I would drink a protein shake, I mean, eventually I stopped, but when I drink a protein shake, I'd immediately break out in hives, like, instantly. So, like, there's so many things now that I understand that I didn't understand before. And I have to admit, I'm getting kind of angry, which is good. That's going to motivate me to do something about it. Anger has always been what's driven me through life. I wish I could say it was love, but no, it's been anger. So today I want you to think about what drives you through life. Is it love or is it anger? I really don't know if love can be the greatest motivator in this kind of world. I would love for it to be, but we always get punished when we're driven by love. I know I'm not alone in that. I'm pretty sure it happens to y'all too. Anytime I've done something for my dogs out of love, which I love them the most, they are my biggest driving forces when it comes to love. And doing the right thing and being a good human, I get extremely punished for wanting them to have the best life that they can. And I'm sure that happens to y'all too. That's how they break women, is when you have children and you want good for them, they punish you. That's why you all have dark empathy. I get that. It doesn't make it right. your pain is just as valid as mine. You know that, right? You know you deserve better, right? We all do. This is not a good way to live. We should be able to be motivated by love. So today, think about what drives you. And when you get angry, do you let that drive you through life as well? What do you do with your anger? How do you channel your anger? For me, it's my revolutionary things. I've just always wanted to be better, and I will keep trying to be better because that's all I really know how to do. I can play dead, and I'm pretty good at it. Even now, I'm still like playing halfway dead, not gonna lie. But this has gotta end soon. This cannot go on forever. So figure out how you are channeling your anger so you don't allow it to eat you inside. Because if you just hold on to that stuff, it'll eat you alive. Probably contribute to your dark empathy and your health problems. So you gotta get it to move through your body. How do you channel your anger? That's the good thought of the day. And then, if you would like, I would love it if you could comment below and let me know anything you can do to help my little revolution here become a big revolution. I would super appreciate it. I love you all. Have a great day.